Hello everyone, welcome back to WBCS for All. I am your friend, philosopher and guide MD Varshit Khan. Today I am going to give you the details of Vedic period and later Vedic period. It is the second series in the history. You can say in the history it is the second lecture, and it is very important, very difficult thing to understand. Even most of the questions come from here in ancient India. So I try to simplify the things. And based upon my observation and experience, I am making this video. First of all, let's have information about me. I got rank 8 in CTO in WBCS Group A 2016. Earlier, I was selected by Zakat Foundation of India for free IAS coaching in New Delhi. I am working as an inspector BCW in Indus Block. I previously worked as LIC development officer. I also qualified in Railway NTPC in CA category. I scored 100.53 in 100 in Tier 1. Even I cleared the cutoff of Monetary Development Officer. I scored maximum interview in West Bengal. And for more information, you can follow me on my Facebook fan page, that is Varshit Khan, MD Varshit Khan. Okay, now let's have a little bit information about Vedic period. As we know that Vedic period starts from 1500 BC to 600 BC, but it can be divided in two parts, that is early Vedic period or only Vedic period, that is from 1500 to 1000 BC, and from 1000 to 600 BC it is called as later Vedic period. Remember, now the Veda, what does Veda means? Veda means Vid. Veda root, it derives from the root word Vid. Vid means to know, and Shruti means to hear. So it is a verbal transmission from one generation to another generation. I tell it to my child tell it to my granddaughter or the grandson. Okay, so this was the method of information at that time, and it is the meaning of the Vedas. And it was, from where do they come? There was a Central Asian theory by Max Muller. It is the most accepted theory, and polar or Arctic region theory by Bal Gangadhar Tilak is also very popular. So according to Max Muller, they came from Central Asia, but according to Bal Gangadhar Tilak, they came from polar region, Arctic region. But the most accepted theory is of Central Asian theory by Max Muller. I will tell you why. Because Aryan was defined as a group of Indo-European language by Max Muller and Sir William Jones, and Penneke, a German scholar who identified the term Aryan with a race. Then what will happen? So they first came to Afghanistan, Punjab region through Khyber Pass in Hindu Kush mountain around 1500 BC, and settled in India and called it is the land of seven river. But at that time they didn't see the Ganga, Yamuna. They only seen the Indus river system. So they called it land of seven region, that is Indus plus five tributary plus Saraswati or Sapta Sindhu, because there are seven Sindhu rivers at that time. According to them, the holy book of Iran, that is the book of Parsi, that Jinda Avesta, indicates entry of Aryans into India via Iran. So it is confirmed that Jinda Avesta also tells they came from Central Asia, because Iran is in the Central Asia, and from Iran they passed through Khyber Pass in Pakistan, Afghanistan region, and they settled there. So it was almost accepted that they came from Central Asia. The councils were Sabha, Samiti, Gan and Vidhata. Earlier they live in tribals. Later the tribal society got divided into three groups. What were the groups? Warrior groups, priest and commoners. But the fourth group, that is the Sudras or Dasas, were those people who were indigenous in nature. So they told them Dasas. The fourth group was added later. The term Varna was not used for color. Aryan being fair and Dasas being dark. Here discrimination starts. Okay. Now, what will happen? I told you that the river, but they told the river with a different name in the Rig Veda. In it, Indus is known as Sindhu. It's okay. The Jhelum, which is also known as Hydaspes, is known as Vitasta in Rig Veda. It is important. They ask question, what was the Rig Vedic name of the rivers? They usually ask the river name of Chenab, that is Askini and Ravi Prusni. These four are very important, but the top threes are important. The Indus we know, Sindhu, Jhelum, Chenab, Ravi. Beast is known as Vipassa, Satlaj, Sutundri. That remember the last three names, Satlaj, Komati and Krummu. These three starts from there later only. Means Satlaj S, then Sutundri S. Gomti, then Gomal. Kurram, then K. And Ghaggar, Drisdavat. Okay? So just try to remember the name. They come in the examination. Make any trick. Okay? Now come to the god. Now Indra was the most powerful god at early Vedic period. It was known as the god of war or warlord. It was also known as Purandhar or breaker of forts. That is why it was the most important god. And it was also associated with the storm and thunder. But the importance is of the because of warlord. After that came Agni. Agni was fire god and it was an intermediary between man and god. Then come to the Varuna. Varuna was personified and identified with water, and it was the means it uphold the natural order. Now they didn't believe in erecting temple or idol worship. What I am telling is about early Vedic period. Okay, they worshipped in open air through yajnas, and at that time there were two system of marriage, that is Anuloma and Pratiloma. Anuloma, when the marriage was of a higher varna man with a lower varna woman, it is allowed, but it was not allowed. What was not allowed? Pratiloma marriage was not allowed. It was the marriage of a lower varna man with a higher varna woman. So at that time caste system was not developed much, but it was the Pratiloma marriage was not you can say accepted in the society. It was criticized. Now let's come to the information about the Aryan. As we know that Aryan means any person who was respected. So Aryans were fond of Soma, Sura, food and dress. What was Soma? Soma was drink at the sacrifices. Whenever some sacrifices were done, they drink Soma, and it use was sanctified by religion. Sura was purely secular and more potent, but was disapproved by priestly poets. Now Aryan followed a mixed economy, that is pastoral plus agriculture, in which cattle played a very important role. Cow was used in, even the cow was a cattle also, and cow was used in agriculture also. The cow was wealth, and human life was equal to 100 cows, and gold coin at that time was Nishka, Krishnal and Satmana. Okay, Gavyuti was the measure of distance and Godholi was the measure of time. Physicians were called Bhishakas, and staple crop of that time was known as Yava, which is also known as barley. Now, what will happen? Now, in the later Vedic period, everything was going fine in early Vedic period. Early Vedic period was very good. But remember, Indus Valley civilization was an urban civilization and Vedic period was a, you can say, rural civilization. Now, what will happen in later Vedic period? Later Vedic period, that is from 1000, also known as painted greaver phase, because at that time, green painting started. Color painting was started, red color, black color, different class painting was started on ports. Now the use of iron also start. Now what they will do? They will cut the forest and they will settle in the fertile land of Ganga, Yamuna, Doab. Now the term Rashtra, indicating territory, first appear in this period. The Samrat is known king. The Samrat is called of the eastern kings. In eastern side, the kings are known as Samrat. In western side, Savrat. In Virat in northern India, Bhoj in southern India, and Raja in the middle kingdoms. So we told Samrat, Virat, Bhoj, Raj. These are the name of the kings in different areas. They are popular in different areas. Okay. Now let's move. Now what will happen? More information. The priest was known as Purohit in later Vedic period. Commander in chief is known as Senapati. Charioteer is known as Suta. Treasurer is known as Sangrahita. Tax collector is known as Bhagduha. And chief queen is known as Mahisi. And game companion is known as Akshavapa. And at that time, the sacrifices, the three sacrifices, Asmaveda, Vajapya, and Rajasu, are very important. Remember, Asmaveda Yag means Asmaveda Yag. When a king performed this sacrifice, it meant control over the area in which the royal horse was uninterrupted. Means they will attire a royal horse and they will lift him, that you run across the kingdom, the horse will run uninterrupted, and who will stop the horse? They have to fight with the king. So what will happen? The area from where the horse ran is of the kingdom of the king, and if was stopped by someone, then the king was ready to fight with those king or those tribes. It means that the ceremony lasted for 3 days, and at the end of which the horse sacrifice was performed. Then what was Vajapya sacrifice? It was a chariot race which was performed in which king must win. Means it was fixed. No one can lead the king. What will they do? They will slow down their horse in the end. It means to re-establish a king supremacy over his people. Then what is Rajasuva? Rajasuva is a sacrifice ceremony which confers supreme power to the king. Prajapati and in later Vedic period, remember the Indra and Agni lost their power. Prajapati become most important. Prajapati was the creator, the supreme. Okay. Now what will happen? What will happen? Now literature will be created. Later Vedic period literature will be created. What were the literature? There were 4 Vedas: Rig Veda, Sam Veda, and Atharva Veda. Rig Veda, Sam Veda, Yajur Veda, and Atharva Veda. The first 3 are written, and the 4th one was later addition. And the first 3 are collectively known as Trayi or Triyu, and each Veda is further divided into Samhitas. There are 800 Upanishads, there are 6 Vedangas, 6 Darshans, which is philosophy, which I will cover in the later video, and there are 4 Upvedas. Okay. Now, what was the importance of Rig Veda? It is very important. It is the oldest book written in the world and it is the oldest Veda. That is why it is called the first testament of mankind. It was the Veda of praise. Here the praise are given in very detailed. It was composed around 700 BC and in Rig Veda there are 1028, that is 1 GB hymns and 1017 suktas. Within 1028, 1017 suktas and 11 valakliyas. There were 10 mandalas. First and 10 mandalas are later addition. There Om was written 1 GB time, that is 1028 times. Jan was written 275 times. 250 hymns were dedicated to Indra and 200 hymns dedicated to Agni. Saraswati is the deity river in the Rig Veda. Then what will happen? In the 10th mandala, there was Purushukta, where the fourfold caste division is given. That the division is given that the Brahmana originate from mouth, Kshatriya from chest, and this way. Okay, now the third mandala, the Gayatri Mantra was given there. Well, Gayatri Mantra was dedicated to Lord Savitri, who is also known as the god of virginity, the solar deity of and offspring of the female Vedic deity Aditi. What was the Sam Veda? Sam Veda is the Veda of Saman or song or melody. It is called the book of chants and Indian music originated with it. Now it was chanted by, remember it was chanted by Udgatri priest at Soma sacrifices. What was Udgatri priest? I will tell you later. So remember, the Udgatri priest chanted the sacrifices during from Samveda. It has 1063 verses, but except 99, all rest have been borrowed from Rig Veda. Now we'll come to the Yajur Veda. It is called Vedas of Yajus or formula. It will deals with the procedures for the performance of sacrifice. It is further divided into Yajur Veda. That is white, that is Shukla Yajur Veda. It contains mantras only, and the black or Krishna Yajur Veda. Here the commentary is given in the prose. But what were given in Yajur Veda? Yajurveda is the primary guide. Yajurveda is the primary guide for Advarya priest. It was for Samved was for Udgatri priest, priest, and Yajurveda was Advarya priest. Means it consists of hymns for the purpose of recitations and rules to be followed during sacrifice, like Rajshua, Vajapya, and it was taught by a school called Tatriyans. Now come to the Atharva Veda. It is entirely different from the other three later editions. Three later edition Vedas of the Atharva Vedas. It is called the Vedas of Atharvarnas or knowledge of magical formulas. It is given how to spell charms, and it is divided into 22 khandas book and have 711 hymns. So this was all about Vedas. Now let's move to the next literature. Then what was the next literature? It was Brahmanas. What was Brahmanas? Brahmanas explains the hymns of the Veda and elaborately discuss the various sacrifices and the rituals along with their mystical meaning. They are written in prose and they are ritualistic in nature. This is all about Brahmanas. Then the Rig Vedas. Which are the Brahmanas attached to Rig Veda? Rig Veda, Atriya and Kausitaki Brahmanas were attached. In Samveda, Panchvis, Jaminiya and Tandya Maha Brahmanas was attached. In Shukla Yajurveda, that is white Yajurveda, Sat Patha, that is 100 skirt path is given. In Krishna Yajurveda, Tatriya Brahman is attached to Krishna Yajurveda. And in Atharva Veda, Gopath. So remember that the Shukla Yajurveda and Black Yajurveda, that is Shukla and Krishna Yajurveda. Is only two parts of Yajurveda. Then come to Aryankas. Aryankas are called the forest book because they were written mainly for the students and hermits living in the jungle. They deal with the mystical symbolism of sacrifice and priestly philosophy. They are concluding portion of Brahmanas. Okay, so what they emphasized on meditation and not on sacrifice. Then they are transitional work from Brahmanas. Brahman philosophy and the Upanishad. So they work on a bridge between the Karma Mark, that is given in Brahmanas, and Gyan Mark, that is given in Upanishad. So Aryanka is in the midway between Brahmanas and Upanishads. Okay, now come to the Upanishads. come to the Upanishads. Upanishads mean to sit down near someone and denote a student sitting near his guru to learn. It is also called as Vedanta. Why? The end of Vedas. Firstly, because they denote the last phase of Vedic period, and secondly because they reveal the final aim of the Veda. They are considered as the main source of Indian philosophy. So they are philosophical in nature. They condemn the ceremonies and the sacrifice. They discuss the various theories of creation of universe and define the doctrine of action, that is karma. Okay. There are 108 Upanishads, and they were composed around 800 to 500 BC. The language is classical Sanskrit and not Vedic Sanskrit. Remember, Rig Veda is attached. You can say the Upanishads which are attached. From Rig Veda, Atriya and Kaustaki are attached. From Sam Veda, Chandogya and Kena Upanishads are attached. From Krishna Yajurveda, Taittiriya Katha and Swastara Upanishads are attached. And from Sukla Yajurveda, Brihadaranyaka and Isha Upanishads are attached. And from Atharva Veda, remember, Prashna and Mundaka Upanishad from Satme Jayate is taken. Mundaka Upanishad is attached from Atharva Veda. Apart from that, Mandukya Upanishad is also attached to Atharva Veda. So these are very factual information which I have collected from different notes. Okay, now come to the Smriti. Smriti means explain the rules and regulation in the Vedic limes. Main are Manusmriti. Manusmriti, there the law is given. The laws are given here in the Manusmriti, and the Manu is also called as the ancient law giver. Now, apart from that, Narada Smriti, Yogi Vakmir Smriti, and Prasas Smriti are given. Then come to the Vedangas. Vedangas are six. Vedangas are the Angas of Vedas. Means they are the parts. They are considered the part, not at the parts of Veda, but they are very important to Vedas. There are six Vedangas. That is Shiksha, Kalpa, Vyakrana, Nirukta, Chanda and Jyotisha. They are asked that which are the Vedangas are attached to which. So remember, Shiksha deals with pronunciation, in which I am very poor. Okay. Kalpa deals with rituals. Vyakrana deals with grammar. I am very poor in grammar also. Nirukta deals with etymology, and Chanda deals with meter, and Jyotisha deals with astronomy. Okay. Now come to the Upveda. Upveda, there are four Upvedas, and each Upvedas are attached to one Veda. Now first of all is the Dhanurveda. Dhanurveda deals with the art of warfare, and it is a Upveda of Yajurveda. Then come to Gandharva Veda. It deals with the music, and it is Upveda of Samveda. Silpa Veda deals with the architecture, and it is Upveda of Atharva Veda. Now come to the Ayurveda. Deals with medicine, and it is Upveda of Rigveda. Whatever I am telling, make a note. It is very important. Soon I will upload the PPT also. Now come to the epic Mahabharat. Mahabharat, attributed to Vyas, describes the period from 10th century BC to 4th century AD. It is also called as Jaya Samhita and Satasri Samhita, and has 1 lakh verses. Now the Ramayana attributed to Valmiki has 25,000 verses. Its composition started in 5th century BC and passes through 5 stages. The 5th stages ended in 12th centuries. Then come to the Mahajanpadas. Now the territory originate. There are 16 Mahajanpadas, but the 5 Mahajanpadas which are very powerful was Magda, Avanti, Kasi, Kausal and Vajji. Okay, now remember the 5 Mahajanpadas, their capital, their area. Now Vajji included 8-9 confederation clans of they are the confederation of 8-9 clans. So what are the clans? Lachavis, Videhans, Jantrikas and Vajjis itself. Now Kushinagar, that is Mahaparinirvana of Buddha, where Buddha died, and Pavapuri, that is the death of Mahavira, where the two capitals of Malla Republic. Isn't not a stranger, remember the thing. Now come to the 6 Mahajanpadas. You can say, and you can also dictate in from there. It will be helped to remember that which Mahajanpada is located where. And here the Mahajanpadas which are marked by me, try to read them, because the Kasi Mahajanpada, the capital was Varanasi. It was present day Varanasi, we all know. Koshala, the capital was Sravasti, the eastern UP. Then come Anga, not important. Magda, its capital was Grivraj or Rajgira. It is present at Patna and Gaya district. Then called Vajji, the capital was Vaishali, and it was the Vaishali district of Bihar. Then Malla Republic, I told you, Kushinagar and Pavapuri, that is south of Vaishali district. Then directly come to Avanti. The capital was Ujjaini and it is in Ujjain district. So these are the Mahajanpadas which you have to remember. Okay, friends, thank you very much and do share and promote. Give your opinion in the comment box. In the next videos, I will upload a lecture on Indian philosophy.